started a couple of years ago, I had no cooking clue what a mockup is. And when I got to know mockups, I thought, you know what, at some point I need to create a video for beginners like myself so that we can make sure that the newbies understand what a mockup is. All I knew was that I wanted this 3D logo and the designer wanted a lot of money to create this logo for me. And then I decided I'm gonna go on YouTube and learn how to create this logo for myself. And then a couple of years later, I'm teaching people how to do the 3D logos on this channel. But if you are a beginner like me a couple of years ago, you would want to know what is a mockup.
What is it?
What is it?
A mockup is a visualization or a design of an app or a web page or a product or a logo that illustrate how the final outcome is going to look like. So this could be on a building, this could be on the logo, this could be on a t-shirt or a cup or a car, it does not matter. Your job as the designer when you are using mockup is you're trying to help the client see what the final outcome is going to look like, how the logo is going to look like outside their building, how the logo is going to look like on a t-shirt or on a computer or on a cell phone. So a mockup's job is to help a customer see what the final product is going to look like. In this video, we're going to be covering how to decide which mockup to use, especially when you're dealing with logos, because most of the time we deal with logos on this channel. It's a good idea for me to show you where to find these mockups that you can use with your designs. And the best place that I would start with would be Canva, because I'm a huge fan of Canva. And when you are on Canva on your homepage, where you're going to find mockups, you're going to scroll down and select apps. This is pre-Canva Create 2024. So I don't know where they're going to put it on Canva Create 2024. But for now, it's under apps. And when you scroll down, I know they have started adding the teams that they've introduced on Canva Create, the marketing, creative, HR, and sales. You're going to scroll down to recommended. And you're going to select mockups. And with the mockups that are linked to Canva, Canva says there's about 8,000 mockups that are here, which includes technology mockups, print mockups, packaging, apparel, and home living. So it depends on what it is that you want your customer to visualize.
Visualize.
Then you can find it on these mockups. There's paid, there's also free. You just need to browse through until you find the one that works with the product that you would like to showcase, and then you select it and then you showcase it to the customer. You can go find this video that we've created to help you with mockups on Canva. One of my favorite websites is unblast.com. I'm going to link all of these websites in the description below so that you can find them and then you can use them. Unblast.com works like the marketplace for mockups. So they pick mockups on different sites and they load them here. That's why it's my favorite, because it helps me find mockups quickly and I'm able to download them and I'm able to use them. So based on whatever it is that you would like to showcase, you can select mockups, fonts, icons, etc. You can choose and then go pick whichever one that you want. So say we would like this ceramic matte mug mockup, and we scroll on it and we like it and we absolutely want to use it, then you can scroll down until you find where it says free download, and then you download. So what you are downloading here is a PSD file, meaning it's a Photoshop file. Sometimes when you want to download, and I don't want to edit this out, I want you to see it. Sometimes when you want to download mockup, it redirects you back to the website that initially uploaded the mockup to unblast.com. And then they show you how you can download it. When you scroll down, you're able to see the instructions from the website. You're able to see how to use it and the license based on how to use this mockup. You can click on download in order for you to access it. And then it tells us that it's going to download in a few seconds. and then it goes to our downloads. You go to your downloads and you find the mockup that you've downloaded. So what I usually do, I drag it to either my desktop or the file that I'm working with, and I unzip it. If you're using a Mac, you'll be able to unzip. You keep using archive utility. If you're using a Windows, you need to have software that unzips your file. So once you unzip your mockup, it will then drag and open up a blue file like this. And when you open it up, it will have the mockups and the images inside on the file. And what you are looking for is a PSD file. So you're looking for a PSD file that's going to be used on Photoshop or Photo-P in order for you to end up having a mockup that looks like these images that they've given you. The first image is a JPEG. The second is a PSD file of the first image. So if you would like to upload a mockup that looks like this one, then you're going to use the PSD file, which is a Photoshop file that you can use as a mockup on Photo-P or Photoshop. And open photop.com, because this is the free version of Photoshop that we use online. So with your photop.com and you've downloaded that mockup from unblast.com, you're going to select open from computer, because you want to open a file that you've downloaded and you want to open a PSD file. So we'll go and find this mockup that we've downloaded. And we can pick any one of these that we would like to use. But again, pick the one that says PSD. So let's pick this last one. You select it and you click on open, and then it starts loading it on the online editor. And this is the beautiful thing about mockups. The way that designers create them, they guide you. And now, because Photo-P works with layers, the designer guides you and says to you, delete this layer, meaning this is the layer that they say delete. So it is already highlighted, as you see that it's highlighted, and you can just scroll down and click delete, and then it's deleted. What you want is this layer that has design on it. Sometimes it will say your logo here or your design here. And in order for you to upload your own image so that it's loaded on there, you're going to go to the section that's grayed out and little spots on there, not at the corner, but on this square shape, and move your mouse over there to double click to open it up. And then it opens up an example of how you should be loading your own logo in order for the design to come through. What I usually do these days, I leave it for now so that it guides me, and I would suggest you do the same. Then you go and you take your own 2D image that you've uploaded and you've made transparent from Canva or whichever design tool that you use. And then you size it and you align it so that it looks and it is the same size that the designer has given you guidance on. And then go hide the example from the designer by clicking on the eye, and then it's gone. In order for the mockup to take, you need to change it to a smart object. You can do this in two methods, either by going file and you select save a smart object, or you press Control or Command S as it shows you there. You just press Command S or Control S, or you click on there. And then you wait a bit for the system to say smart object updated. That means it has changed it and it has attached it to the mockup. Then where you're going to find your design? On the first tab that you've opened initially, and your logo is going to be added on the design and your mockup is done. So when you're happy, again, using the guidance of the design, if you've made it bigger than the designer's guidance, this logo would have been taller outside the cup. So follow the guidance. In order for you to then download this so you can showcase it to your customer, you're gonna go file and you're gonna export it. It depends on how you would like to showcase to your customer. Would you like to give them a PNG, a JPEG, a SVG? It's up to you. Then you can select whichever one that you want, and then it would open up the save option, and then you can name it if you want, reduce the width and the height. If you're happy with all of this, you just click on save, and then when you go to your downloads, your design is then saved as a PNG and it's done. We're back on photopea.com. Once we get here, we are able to open from computer, which you've just seen. But in this step, we want to show you the templates that are loaded on Photopea. By the way, you can also load templates if you are a designer and you have amazing templates that you want to share. You can load them by watching this other video that I've created, and I'm also going to link. So it might be very confusing and daunting to decide which template to use in which instance. I would suggest that it depends on the type of client that you have that you want to showcase the product to, and it depends on each taste of a designer.
Attaboy, trust your instincts.
Oh yeah.
So I use a couple of these mockups and I get used to a few and they become my favorites. You will also start having favorites that you will use. It's just that play around with different types of mockups. See which ones work with a product that you want to showcase or a logo that you want to showcase. And then sometimes you tell that this does not work, and then you change it to something else. However, have lots of fun with your creativity and your designing. Right now, I think it's the best thing that you could do for yourself to go to our playlist on shapes on Canva and go get some more inspirations on designs that you could be creating when it comes to your designs. Thank you so much for joining me on this video. I will see you on our next video.